Good morning, sir. I'm pleased to meet you through this conference. Dear colleagues, good morning. Let me first thank the organizers, the Victoria Albert Museum and Yale Institute for the Preservation of Cultural Heritage for this important conference, and special thanks for Professor Stephen Simon, Director of the Institute for the Preservation of Cultural Heritage. Also, I could not participate personally with you. I still believe that it is really important to present the Syrian Directorate General of the Antiquity and Museum voice to be heard in your meeting via this video message. Today, I will be sharing with you a brief introduction of what we have done in DGIM during the saddening crisis, our vision, the methods conducted, the results achieved locally and internationally, and the role of international community. The Syrian cultural heritage are witnessing the most violent and dangerous attacks during the recent crisis, the latest development of the painful events, as well as the absence of the specialized government institution and the archaeological authorities in some region, contributed greatly to the aggravation of the risk befalling the Syrian cultural heritage. Systematic clandestine excavations carried out by professional armed gangs, smuggling cultural objects grew remarkably across the Syrian borders. Vast regions extending along the geography of Syria are now classified as distressed cultural areas, such as Sud of Hasaki, Deir ez-Zor countryside, Dura Oropos, Idlib countryside, like Ibla, Dites village, Aleppo countryside, and also Wadi Yarmouk in Dar'a, Hama countryside, Apami, etc. The most devastating and irreversible losses to Syria's rich heritage are the result of looting. Many areas in the countries outside state control, a mafia from neighborhood countries hired hundreds of people to strip site. Thieves have brought in antiquities experts to advise them about the best places to dig, and in many cases they are using bulldozer. This image, what you see here, between 2012, Mari and Dura Oropos, and also 2014, 70% of these two sites damaged by looting. Example of Ibla also, but through this image we have a lot of destruction, but we tried it with mediation of the local community reduce the damage on this site. Another example of Palmyra, what happened in the tombs of Palmyra through this crisis. We recuperated through this crisis about 120 statues saved by looter from these tombs. Another example of the damage, it is clashes. Archaeological sites have been transformed to battlefield. What you see here, unfortunately, what happened between Aleppo before and Aleppo after, it is destruction. Aleppo is an example of the bad situation in the Syria through this crisis. We have about, in our map assessment, about 140 buildings damaged in this site. And you know also what happened in the souk of Aleppo in the old city, about 1,000 market damaged by fire. Example of another city, it is Homs, what happened in this crisis. We have Ma'loula, it's a small city beside of Damascus, about 70 kilometers. Some building in Damascus also damaged, but in Damascus, fortunately, the situation is very quiet. The six sites registered on the UNESCO World Heritage List were officially listed as being in danger in June 2013 in Cambodia meeting. The terrorist ISIS acts destroyed all type of the Syrian heritage site by demolition, burning, vandalism. The damage were various in degrees. Local break the massive building blocks from ancient buildings into smaller stones to sell or use to rebuilding people who were displaced due to the clashes raised inside the archaeological site. Here it is example of destruction of the stone. What happened? It's a very problem. Syrian Museum have witnessed the theft to archaeological artifacts in Raqqa, example Ma'arat Nu'man, but small object in Ma'arat Nu'man, two objects from Hama. But also we have another kind of the museum damaged by looting. It is a museum of Deir Atiyah, the hole of the arm, and some object from the museum, folkloric museum in Aleppo, and there is also. But in general, I confirm you that 99% of the collection of the museum in all the Syria are in safe places till now. Is example of what happened in Raqqa, because we had a lot of looting in the museum, because we had three boxes located in the central bank of Raqqa, but unfortunately it is it is saved by group in this group army in this city. What happened in the site of Raqqa, also Herakla houses, also we have a lot of destruction about this object stored in this storage. In general, they are it is object from the archaeological machines. Example of what happened, the kind of the object looking from the museum of Deir Atiyah. For this museum of mosaic, it is very important mosaic museum, but in general the situation is very good, without 30 pieces of art like ceramic glasses stolen from this museum. What is our measure taken on the ground? Secure, salvage and stabilize museums objects, burglar alarm were installed, and number of guard and patrols were increased. Here we are a lot of the person working about the packing. Here example of the gate, it is very strong gates of the National Museum, and all the windows, all the gates fortified through this crisis. Documentation also, we do it a lot of the work about documentation for the damage assessment, and for website, and to photograph the majority absolutely of the collection in the museum. We have a hard system of the documentation do it through this crisis. For the raising awareness also campaign, we launched a lot of the campaigns through the schools, the street, conference, how we can to do together about this cultural heritage to preserve. Communicated with the local community, we do it a lot of the work. We in this area under control of the some group armies, we do it a lot of the contact with the local community, how we can to neutralize our cultural heritage. Here is example of the mosaic founded by the local community beside of Damascus, about 40 kilometers. The local community accepted to send this mosaic to National Museum, and we preserve it now, this mosaic, in our in safe places. More than 6,000 archaeological artifacts were returned with a treasure containing 1,600 silver plated bronze coin. We worked a lot of the project of the restoration in the Mosque Umayyad of Damascus, and also training for the students of Damascus University. Openness to the international dimension by maintaining the most active cooperation with all international agencies concerned with the protection of the antiquity like UNESCO, and cooperating with ICOMOS, ICROM, ICOM, World Monument Fund in New York, ARC, World Heritage in Bahrain, Interpol, DIE, etc. We do it a lot of the work through this crisis. It is example of the meeting and training in UNESCO Paris and UNESCO Beirut also. We sent a lot of the student employees for the training in the office of UNESCO. And we had a lot of international company in Germany. They do it a lot of the work conference and database working mapping, building capacity in Germany and Italy also. So 2014, we had a lot of the activity in this country. In Japan also, they started through this year. And for the England, we had excellent work with Durham University about database and also for the mapping of the sites in the Syria. Our main concern at this stage is to protect the Syrian cultural heritage with all its components and to keep it safe as much as possible, since it belongs to all Syrians, respective of their views and political orientation. The DGM has done this by attempting to avoid using the issue of antiquities for political agenda, which might affect them. The dangers surrounding the Syrian archaeological heritage are growing beyond our capabilities and limited resources. They cannot by any means defeat our will. We call on the international community to recognize the validity of this effort and provide assistance and support for our work. The international community would need to bear in mind that the Syrian cultural heritage is part of the world heritage of humanity and that the loss of any of its components is a loss to all the humanity. In addition, I would like to urge the international community to effectively stop extremist resources to trade the antiquities and to pressure on the neighboring countries to prohibit illicit trafficking of the Syrian archaeological heritage. Hence, the time has come to take action before it is too late to protect our heritage against a disaster that is painful for all of us. I wish for your conference all the success. Thank you very much.